Dakota has gotten into physical fights with other girls, and these girls film the fights. This summer, she was at a park and gave a girl a black eye.
I'm not a
pushover.
I will defend myself, and if you talk bad on my name, I'm going to come at you.
People are afraid of her, you know, not to make her mad. For safety's sake, Dakota sits at lunch with the sheriff and her teachers.
In the category of small worlds, it's interesting to note that Dakota and I have been suspended from the same school district. We both come from the same streets. Let's take a look at this.
Whatever she wants, and it is impossible to parent Dakota at this point. She has no respect for authority at all.
I've got enough disrespect for the day.
While I try to instill control over her, things get out of control, and I've had to restrain her, put her in a headlock, sit on her, hold her hair, just to get her under control. I've slapped her in the face, and she slapped me back. Currently enrolled in an alternative school for troubled teens. The main reason she's at the alternative school is because it starts an hour later.
You're out till 2 a.m. You refuse to get up and go to school. You want to
every morning, I yell and cuss at her to get out of bed, to get her to school. I was addicted to cocaine while she was growing up. Dakota uses it against me. Her perception is that I was a horrible mother, gone all the time, and that's simply not true. Her grandmother was always there, always present, and as was my roommate. I was the best mother I could be. I told her I loved her every day. I took her to the zoo. I spent a lot of time with her. But she doesn't listen. She doesn't respect me. Dakota is out of control.
Okay, so you've been listening to what we've been talking about, right?
Yes, sir.
What did you want to say?
She is right. I wasn't there, but my mother was there, and my roommate was there, and she was never alone. And I apologize for my past, and I was clean for 3 years, and then 2 years ago I relapsed, and I lost.
The one thing that Dakota does say, and she gives you full credit for this, you lost custody of her, and she does give you full credit for the fact that you worked hard, did what you needed to do to get her back. You do give her credit for that, right?
Complete credit, yes.
Yeah. You were first in a foster home, then a group home, right?
Yes.
We actually have some tape about that. Let's look at your foster experience. Let's hear what you have to say about that.
Because of me not going to school, my parents had to go to truancy court. While they were there, they both failed a drug test, and I was taken out of their care.
I went to a party on the Friday night before the Monday court date. At the party, I did cocaine, and I knew going into the courtroom that they would drug test me. I immediately lost custody of Dakota that day.
I was outraged with my parents. I was upset and so stressed out. To a worse home. The couple that I stayed with were alcoholics and took heavy prescription medication. They had firearms all over the house. I would wake up all the time and there would be screaming and arguing. The woman's husband had severe PTSD from Vietnam. He would have panic attacks, grab the gun in his side table because he thought somebody was trying to shoot him in his sleep. It was super terrifying. I immediately called my social worker and figured out a new placement for myself. We had to clean, wash, all our phone calls were monitored 24/7. I continuously kept asking myself why this is happening to me. It was totally unfair. I did not fight for me at all. He didn't try anything in his power to get me back. He stood in the sidelines and watched like it was just a ball game. My mom worked so hard.
rhetorically or sarcastically. Has anybody ever taken the time to seriously teach you how to parent?
No.
Because you said some things in your tape piece that were shocking to me. Mm-hmm. We're going to take a break. And when we come back, I want to talk about what you said in that tape piece. And I want to talk about what situation you're creating now mm-hmm. for her. And what you're vulnerable to at this point. We'll be right back. You think you might want to take that down before the judge pulls it up?
You can judge me all you want.
Well, I'm going to judge you. The judge is going to judge you. And later.
Yeah, my mom has gotten in the fist fights. Maybe like 75% of the time, like I throw first. You know, I'm here trying to get help. Hello, Dr. Phil. It's nice to meet you.